This all-you-can-eat dim sum buffet sitting in a beautiful Chinese garden in Sydney CBD is fancy. They take the dim sum classics and put their own spin on it. The tranquility of the garden contrasts greatly with the hustles in the city. Is this your first time seeing a dim sum buffet? Does it work like other buffets? Is it worth the price? And finally, HungryAnna, do you have any tips or discount secrets? Let's get right into it. It works a little differently from other buffets. It's not self-serve. At the start, they bring a small portion of everything on the menu for you to try. After the dish is served once, you can start asking the waitress for more. There are 18 dishes. Firstly, let's look at their buns and dumplings. Strictly, my favorite wrapper? Definitely dumpling! Xiao Long Bao, or soup dumpling, is not traditionally a dim sum dish. Due to its recent popularity, it's now commonly served at such places. If you're expecting Din Tai Fung style, you might be disappointed. The skin here is slightly thicker, less soupy, and the flavor is more pokey. I wouldn't order another serving, but it's enjoyable nonetheless. Any dumpling or bun with soup in it is exciting! This crystal prawn dumpling, skin is glistening, not quite translucent. As I bite into it, though I can feel the firm snappiness of prawn flesh, the rest is mushy. Overall, lacking flavor. Hello, I'm Jade Prawn Dumpling. Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of them all?
You are the fairest. However, the taste is much like the crystal prawn dumplings.
This dessert bun, the brown mushroomy look on the outside makes it appetizing. What flavor do you think the bun is? I'm anticipating either mushroom or chocolate flavor. However, I'm presented with sweetened duck egg yolk inside. Feels a little incoherent. Sometimes surprises are great, but not in this case. Duck yolk's richness is under-delivered. Well, appetizing presentation at least. With these three dishes, I will not order again. I hate giving negative feedbacks because the restaurant is probably working very hard to provide its guests a good experience. Now with the bad news out of the way, let's look at 5 dishes I would order again.
Yay!
Coming number 5, it's called Snow Mountain Pork Buns. The look is intriguing. Does it look like a snow mountain? But it's not white. Looks like a scone. I pick it up. Instead of being soft and fluffy like traditional pork buns, it's firm and crusty. A bit crumbly like baked cookies, but not as brittle. You know the soft cookies in between doughy and crunchy? The filling also comes in bigger quantity. Pork is chewy. Sweetness provides a welcome contrast to savoriness while being complemented by a hint of spice. The juicy filling is a nice contrast to the crusty skin. Personally, I'm not a big fan of all pork buns, too sweet for me. But if you normally enjoy them like my friends do, you most likely will love this. Fun fact, we often hear people talking about umami. Do you know what it means? It's the 5th basic taste, we all know that. What most people don't know is it's the taste of MSG in the protein of savory foods, such as bacon and cheese. It's obvious how important protein is for our body function, therefore we naturally crave it. MSG is also in human milk. It, combined with sugar, are the two things that get babies drinking. MSG is much less harmful than your table salt. Coming in number 4, the siumai has a good amount of pork fat, giving a juicy and silky mouthfeel. Bite is springy. Prawn inside has delicate and snappy complexity to the texture. Pork's umami is well seasoned by the pepperiness, animated by subtle spiciness, and intensified by salt. I'm sensitive to salt. All siumais are on the salty side for me. If you normally don't mind, you will find the level just enough to give you the satisfying ding. How much do 1,000 kilograms of dumplings weigh? Wonton! Coming in number 3, wontons are just dumplings wrapped slightly differently in my opinion, especially when not eaten with soup. Chili oil enhances the wonton skin's slipperiness while giving it some heat. Very mild, however. Don't need to worry if you can't eat spicy. What's the filling like, you ask? It's big, firm, and meaty. Chewy and flavorful. It would be perfect if the filling was a tad smaller for better skin to filling ratio. Nonetheless, it's delightful. Coming in number 2, this pork and chive dumpling has so much soup inside. Might as well call it Din Tai Fung Xiao Long Dumpling. Oh my god, do you see this? Totally caught me off guard. I wasted most of mine. Well, at least I get to share my lesson with you so that you will know. Pork and chive are such a classic combination as dumpling filling. The pungent garlic-like flavor in chives can stand up to the heavy meatiness, balancing off the fat. Yum! I grew up eating raw garlic. Absolutely love this. Warning, do not eat more than 2 if you're meeting someone important after. The chives will give you bad breath. Coming number 1, woohoo!
If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you don't, smash hard on the thumbs down and maybe tell me in the comment section below what you don't like about it. Back to the video.
Coming number 1, woohoo! Is your vegetable dumpling. Your is the Chinese name of an edible mushroom native to China, but it's popular in other regions in Asia too, like Japan. Besides the savory taste, it's well known for its antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties. The skin is translucent when you bite into it. Unlike previous dumplings, instead of being meaty and substantial, it's light. The mushroom is crunchy, and the savory juice fills your mouth with fragrant umami. Corn is subtly sweet and shallow to make the bite vibrant. Seasoning heightens all the natural flavors from the plants. What a refreshing bite! Love it when vegetables' original flavor are central to a dish. This one stands out the most. Are you hungry yet? What's your favorite dim sum dish? Does any of these look good for you? Let me know in the comment section below. Would I recommend this buffet? Next episode is for duck pancakes, oysters, and more. It's right here on your screen.